Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just in response...
Move to strike the last word?
Yes, move to strike the last word. Thank you.
And ladies recognized.
In response to my colleague from Florida, you cannot argue things both ways. You cannot say that the president was so concerned about Ukraine that he released aid, which is true. He released aid in 2017. He released aid in 2018. And then suddenly he became concerned in 2019, right after Vice President Biden announced that he was going to run. So if your argument is that he was so concerned about Ukraine that he released aid in 2017 and 2018, then why in 2019, after the Department of Defense cleared Ukraine on charges of corruption, why then did he decide he was so concerned about corruption that he was not going to release aid?
Because
that, that makes, I'm sorry, I'm not yielding. I am not yielding. I am not yielding.
They got a new president. That's why.
The gentlelady has the time. The committee will be in order and people will not interrupt.
They got a new president who was...
This is not proper here.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
The gentlelady will continue.
They got a new president who was known to be an anti-corruption fighter. So that argument has no weight whatsoever. Now, if you want to argue that the president was so concerned about corruption at that particular moment, you have to look at the whole record of U.S. policy and our agreement that the Department of Defense would look under certain conditions before they release military aid to determine whether or not a country had satisfied those requirements around corruption. And the Department of Defense released that report. Nowhere between the time that Donald Trump withheld aid and the time that he released that aid, was there an additional assessment required or done? In fact, the Department of Defense decided they didn't need to do another assessment because they had already done the assessment. So at the end of the day, I have only two questions for my colleagues on the other side. And these are the two questions. Forget about President Trump. Forget about President Trump. Will any one of my colleagues on the other side say that it is an abuse of power to condition aid on official acts? Well, forget about President Trump.
We do it.
Forget about President Trump. Is any one of my colleagues willing to say that it is ever okay for a president of the United States of America to invite foreign interference in our elections? Not a single one of you has said that so far.
I'll say.
I yield to my colleague from Texas.
Will the gentlelady yield so we can answer the question?
Thank you.
I'll be glad to answer the question.
Do you want
to answer the question?
I want to break this down.
The gentlelady has the time. And
she asked us a question.
The members here know perfectly well it is out of order to interrupt members who have the time.
Unless they ask you a question.
Gentlelady has yielded to whom?
She asked us a question.
Gentlelady yielded to whom? Ms. Escobar now has the time. Yielded
Thank
by
you,
Ms. Jayapal.
Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Representative Jayapal. I want to break this down in simple terms for the American public because our Republican colleagues are working overtime to try to convince us that we didn't see what we saw with our own eyes and we didn't hear what we heard with our own ears. Let's bring it down to an example that was used during the hearing. If a community suffers a natural disaster and the governor of the state has aid that will help that community, but calls the mayor of your community and says, I want you to do me a favor though, and conditions with giving the aid to the community on the police chief smearing his political opponent, has there been a crime? The answer is yes. And that governor would go to jail. If that governor later releases the aid after he got caught, it doesn't matter. He still committed the crime. Furthermore, if that governor says during the investigation, I'm going to defy the subpoenas, we're going to fight the subpoenas, guess what would happen to that governor? He's committed a crime. He would go to jail. If the governor then tried to cover up his wrongdoing, cover it up so that his people, his constituents, couldn't see his wrongdoing, what would happen to that governor? Did he commit a crime? Yes, he would go to jail. So as wildly as they're trying to convince you that there was no wrongdoing, I want the American public to understand what is going on here. It's clear as day. We've seen it with our own eyes. We've heard it with our own ears. Facts matter. I yield back.
Thank you, Ms. Escobar. And I would just again close with this single question. Is it ever okay for a president to condition official action on personal gain? I yield back.